Hi, it's Rob, and today I'm over at our Bannatyne project to talk a little bit about load-bearing walls and point loads. What a load-bearing wall is a framed wall that's picking up and distributing a load from overhead uniformly over the distance of the wall. So for in this example, we've got a floor system that actually terminates around the stair opening. So this load-bearing wall is picking up the whole structural load of that floor system and transferring it down this wall. And then actually you'll see over here that load-bearing wall continues below and is actually continued and transferred down to the concrete footing. The concrete footing ultimately supports all structural load of the house. Everything has to come down and get transferred. All weight has to get transferred down to the concrete footing. This is actually what holds the house up. What you'll notice inside this load-bearing wall, so for in the great scheme of things, we've got, you know, single 2x4s framed at 16 inches on center as a standard construction. However, what you'll find is beneath the end of this beam, since there's a greater opening, you've got a greater load being concentrated on one spot. So what we have to do is we install what's called a point load beneath that corner of the post. So this point load is carried down in a 4-ply 2x4 post, which basically comes down to the main floor and then again will be transferred from the main floor down to the basement concrete footing. In this case, a greater example of that is actually where we have a triple beam hung off a double beam, hung off another triple beam, hung off a fourth triple beam, and actually being picked up by this point load. So in this case, we've got so much weight all being supported in one spot. So in this case, we've got a 6-ply 2x4 point load, which is picking up that beam weight, which is holding everything else up here. It gets transferred all the way down again to the main floor system, and then below from the main floor system all the way down to the concrete footing. So in most situations, you'd have load-bearing walls under your floor systems. In some cases, because you like to have an open concept house, you'd like to have, you know, great big openings, you need to have point loads anytime you have a beam and a span exceeding what a standard 16 inch opening can carry. So we've got a point load here and a point load here carrying this opening. We've got a point load here and a point load here carrying this greater opening. So this is structurally how we support the weight of a house. And again, you can have it in a wall form, you can have it in a point load form. If you want to have everything wide open, you could put posts and beams everywhere and actually have, you know, virtually no walls if you wanted to, but again, you'd have to have everything transferred down ultimately to your concrete footings. And that's how we frame a house structurally.